The African continent is full of the most wild and exotic animals in the world. And why not create a video game experience where you, the player, go interact with those animals?
Lions, large elephants, and rhinos, and sneaky crocodiles.
You can get right up close and play with those animals like they were your buddies in the backyard, but you're doing it in the wild kingdom of Africa.
We really wanted our art style to reflect the colorful art of Africa.
The art style is just very playful.
We went for something a bit more cartoony. Yes, it's Africa, but we tried to make it as imaginative as possible.
There are all kinds of varied microclimates.
There are deserts, and there are savannas. There are swamps with dirty water and volcanic areas, and just gorgeous landscapes with waterfalls and mountains.
We want to give the player the chance to experience what it's like to be out in the wild in some of the most beautiful and dangerous and exotic terrain on Earth.
The game is about traveling through this world that needs your help.
There's a tree of life. It provides all the fertility for all the soil and all the animals that live in this world. And there's something wrong with it. And you as a player have to discover what that is. And the way you discover it is you enlist the help of these animal friends that you meet along the way. You're given lots of goals and challenges that you need to undertake in the game. And you need to use the animal to help solve those goals or figure out those challenges.
So to become friends with your animal, you'll need to have them play with them or feed them something they like. So for instance, if you make friends with a rhino, you can be able to break trees or even rocks. If you make friends with a zebra, you're able to kick things around. If you can make friends with, you know, an elephant, you can water things and make plants grow.
The lion in the game is a prowler, he's a hunter.
Your hippo is your digger.
So each animal has a unique ability, which means playing with animals is always different and unique.
Well, if you ever wanted to drive a hippopotamus around, we let you do that in SimAnimals Africa, but it doesn't start until you actually build a relationship with that animal.
There's also an enormous amount of things to find and unique items.
It's a game about discovery. Discovering unique plants, unique insects, unique fish. Discovering the huge surprises that pop up out of nowhere when you get through some major goal.
The DS actually has some very unique characteristics that we know the DS players are just going to love. First of all, you can play with a buddy.
We have all the same animals as the Wii version, plus a few extras.
Meerkat, there's an aardvark, there's a cheetah, and then there's the parrot who actually will talk to you throughout the game, and he's your guide throughout the whole playing of the game.
The game's about the animals. There's so much to see and do, we really think you'll like it.
I mean, who would think you could actually go build a bond with a lion? Well, you can in SimAnimals Africa.